السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 5, where we listen to some of the verses of the Quran, that the subject of it is the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the earth, the creation of Allah, the favors of Allah, the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, for us to reflect upon it, because that's the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned His creation in the Quran, He mentions them for a reason, for a great wisdom. And the benefit of that for us as human beings, as creation of Allah, as slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Him alone, is that to increase our iman, to establish the clear evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, to taste the sweetness of al-iman when we remember and reflect upon the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never changes. When we see the creation of Allah, we see how weak they are, how deficient they are, how they are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His actions and His names and attributes, we see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most perfect. Nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll go through some of the verses in Surah Az-Zumar, where these verses are talking about some of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. Try to listen, inshallah, and learn even how to recite and to reflect upon these verses by the will of Allah. But before we start, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We have with us Sheikh Mustafa Ahmadi from Afghanistan. Welcome to the program. Alaykum as-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi. Sheikh Ahmad Rajab from Egypt, welcome to the program.
Welcome.
We have Sheikh Fardeen Raoufi from Afghanistan. Welcome to the program.
Shukran. Barakallahu
feekum. Sheikh Hamza Yahya from Tanzania. Welcome to the program.
Marahaban.
Barakallahu feekum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for coming. We'll start, inshallah ta'ala, with verses from Surah Az-Zumar, verse number 5 to verse number 7. And Sheikh Mustafa, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق يكور الليل على النهار ويكور النهار على الليل وسخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لأجل مسمى ألا هو العزيز الغفار خلقكم من نفس واحدة ثم جعل منها زوجها وأنزل لكم من الأنعام ثمانية أزواج يخلقكم في بطون أمهاتكم خلقا من بعد خلق في ظلمات ثلاث ذلكم الله ربكم له الملك لا إله إلا هو فأنى تصرفون إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم ولا يرضى لعباده الكفر وإن تشكروا يرضه لكم ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى ثم إلى ربكم مرجعكم فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون إنه عليم بذات الصدور.
إن شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. The surah, Surah Az-Zumar, starts with the mention of the book of Allah, the Quran. And this is the sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that were revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The surah talks about sincerely, purely worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and establishing the evidences to prove that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. So therefore, after that, the verses that we just heard, it's about the physical signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created that are evidences that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. So as we heard the verses saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth by the truth, for the sake that these ayat from Allah are created so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, for people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the night and the day, one comes after the other, and He created the sun and the moon. All of it is to a specific time, and then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for it to be destroyed, it will be destroyed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Most Forgiver, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Created you, meaning all of the human beings, the mankind, from one soul. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made from this one soul, which is Adam alayhi salam, his wife, and brought down to you from the cattle 8 pairs, and that is the camels and the cows and the sheep and the goats. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human being, as it's mentioned in the verse, يَخْلُقُكُمْ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates you in the wombs of your mother, one stage after another, in 3 darknesses, in the darknesses of the womb of the mother, and so on. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ لَهُ الْمُلْكِ. This statement has to have its place in our hearts, that this is the creation of Allah. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord. He has the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth. Therefore, لا إله إلا هو, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what take people away from the tawheed and the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The next verse stating that if people disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich. He is in no need of His creation. They are the ones in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pleased with them to have a matter of disbelief. Everything is by the permission of Allah with regards to the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the religious decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pleased with them to be in the state of kufr and disbelief. And if they are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them. And therefore, al-shukr versus al-kufr. Al-shukr, to be grateful to Allah versus disbelief. And to be grateful to Allah, that means for a person to be a Muslim, to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as one of the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody is to bear the sin of another. And everyone shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He would inform them of what they used to do. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-knower of what's in the hearts, what is concealed, because the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. The surah, as we would hear, is establishing the evidences of the tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And definitely one of these great and very important and strong evidences is to look into the creation of Allah and to take this as an evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. We'll continue, inshallah ta'ala, from the same surah, and after that verses 8 to 10. And Sheikh Ahmad, please go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإذا مس الإنسان ضر دعا ربه منيبا إليه وإذا مس الإنسان ضر دعا ربه منيبا إليه ثم إذا خوله نعمة نسي ما كان يدعو إليه من قبل نسي ما كان يدعو إليه من قبل وجعل لله وجعل لله أندادا بكفرك قليلا. قل تمتع بكفرك قليلا إنك من أصحاب النار. أمن هو قانت آناء الليل ساجدا وقائما للذين أحسنوا في هذه الدنيا حسنة. قل يا عبادي الذين آمنوا اتقوا ربكم للذين أحسنوا في هذه الدنيا حسنة وأرض الله واسعة إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب.
Inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses talks about the nature of the human beings and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the human beings and how to protect ourselves from the evil within our own selves. That if the human being is touched by any harm, he would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and invoke and make dua, and he would return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted him and gave him one of his favors, he would forget what he used to make dua before. And he would make with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala partners to deviate away from the path of Allah. How evil this attitude is, that a person would only remember his Lord whenever he is in time of distress and need, and when he is in time of having the favors of Allah at ease, he would forget and turn away and even would associate partners with Allah. So therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet ﷺ to say to such people, قُلْ تَمَتَّعْ بِكُفْرِكَ قَلِيلًا إِنَّكَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. Say, O Muhammad ﷺ, enjoy your disbelief for a little while, because indeed you are from among the people of the hellfire. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this contrast between the believers, those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who do not, and those who are the opposite of this. أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ أَنَا أَلَيْهِ. The one that is qanit, in state of devotion and worship, during the night making sujood and making qiyam, prostrate and stand up, and in the salah, warning and being warned against the punishment of the hereafter, hoping for the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the fear and the hope. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, are they the like, are they the same, those who know and those who do not know? Indeed, those who remember are the people of reason. So that means praising the people of knowledge. That means they're not the like of those who are ignorant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling, ordering the Prophet to call the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who believe, ittaqu rabbakum. And this is such an honor for the people to be among those who accepted the message from Allah, the believers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, is ordering them to fear the Lord and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and giving them the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if they do good in this life, they would have a goodly life. And the earth of Allah is so vast. That means don't confine yourself to a place that you would have to fall into disbelief, wal'ayadhu billah, because you're oppressed in the land. Go somewhere where you can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed, those who are patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them reward without any account whatsoever, everlasting mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shows again the virtues of the believers when they're patiently obeying the orders of Allah. We continue inshallah ta'ala and with verses 22 to 26 from the same surah. And Sheikh Fardeen, please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء ومن يضلل الله فما له من هاد أفمن يتقي بوجهه سوء العذاب يوم القيامة وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون كذب الذين من قبلهم فأتاهم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون فأذاقهم الله الخزي في الحياة الدنيا ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses in Surah Az-Zumar, really there's a lot of benefits from it, and it's establishing foundations and methods of the deen. One of which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in Sharah al-Sadr. Al-Sadr is the chest, and it literally means that the breast becomes wide, the chest becomes wide. It's a sign of happiness and tranquility and comfort. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this to the Prophet ﷺ when he said, Alam nashrah laka sadrak. So in Sharah al-Sadr, to have this spaciousness within oneself is by the deen of Islam. Otherwise, if it's not the deen of Islam, a person, he finds it tight. And people even say that, he finds it tight inside. The deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it spacious, at ease for the person, because a person is basically fulfilling the purpose of one's life. And when a person is upon the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is guided, then this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from them. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned those who have hardness in their hearts from the dhikr of Allah, from the remembrance of Allah. And the hardness of the heart is such a disease that the way to soften the heart is with the dhikr of Allah, the remembrance of Allah, to be obedient to Allah. The sins harden the hearts, and of course the worst thing is to associate partners with Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the Qur'an, the best speech, the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the Qur'an is in such a way that it has two meanings or two ways of doing things. That the verses that talks about the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the skin of the believers shivers out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and have this feeling to it out of the fear of Allah, then it relaxes and it softens when the person would recite the Quran and the verses that talks about the rewards from Allah, the love of Allah, and the like of this. So that would make them be in the state of dhikr and the remembrance of Allah. This is the guidance from Allah, and whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead astray, no one can guide. How the Quran makes the hearts and makes the body react in different ways with the punishment of Allah, with the reward from Allah. This is how the Quran and the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so perfect. And then talking about the people in the hereafter and those who would be thrown into the hellfire, the zalimeen, the wrongdoers, and it will be said to them to taste what they used to earn, and it doesn't benefit them that they would try to defend themselves, and they followed the paths of the nations before, so the punishment came to them from where they do not expect it as a result of their evil actions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them in state of disgrace in this life, and the punishment in the hereafter is much bigger. If they know, that means they would repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is the sad reality of those who turn away from the truth after it's been presented to them. We'll go on inshallah ta'ala, and this time continuing the verses number 27 to 31. And Sheikh Hamza, go ahead and read for us inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. وَلَقَدْ ضَرَبْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ وَلَقَدْ ضَرَبْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ قرآنا عربيا غير ذي عوج لعلهم يتقون ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجلا سلما لرجل هل يستويان مثلا الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة عند ربكم تختصمون.
Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses talks about examples or parables that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set in the Quran for people to remember. And this Quran and the amthal in it and the parables, it's by the Arabic language that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for his final revelation. That is not crooked, it's straightforward, it's very clear in its expression, it's very powerful with the linguistics and the power of the language that makes it amazing. And especially with that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech is nothing as the like of it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the example and for people to reflect upon it, and that's from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something that they can relate to. A man that he has partners that they're all against one another. They're not in harmony, they're all against one another. And imagine someone is like in that state, or being enslaved by so many of the owners, and they're fighting with each other, versus someone that is as a partner with another man and they're in peace and so on. So shuraka, partners, they're all fighting and bickering towards one another. And two partners that are at ease with one another, are they the same? Are they the like? People, of course, would choose the second type, in which they would have all kinds of peace and kinds of goodness and so on. That's why, alhamdulillah, bil aktharum la ya'lamun. And this is the example for those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they worship other than Allah, versus the heart of those who are at peace, because they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And this is how it's mentioned earlier, as we said, with the deen of al-Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the matter spacious for the person. Otherwise, when a person worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's all kinds of tightness and misery That's why many people, they would leave it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stating to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he will die and everybody will die. Creation of Allah, everybody will die. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتُ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. The Prophet ﷺ will die and his enemies will die. But then there's major difference between after this life for the Prophet ﷺ versus the disbelievers. And the Prophet ﷺ now is living a most perfect life, more perfect life than this life. And the disbelievers are being punished. And then in the Day of Judgment, everybody will be disputing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. And the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the promise of the truth to the believers, and the disbelievers have been promised the hellfire. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the verses of Surah Az-Zumar, but right after the break, so stay with us inshallah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala ashraf al-mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome back, and still with verses from Surah Az-Zumar to get to know the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it as an evidence to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala and with verses number 36 to 38 from Surah Az-Zumar, and Sheikh Ibrahim Kumar inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Alaysa Allahu bikafin 'abdahu ويخوفونك بالذين من دونه ومن يضلل الله فما له من هاد ومن يهد الله فما له من مضل أليس الله بعزيز ذي انتقام ولئن سألتهم من خلق السماوات والأرض ليقولن الله قل أفرأيتم ما تدعون من دون الله إن أرادني الله بضر هل هن كاشفات ضره أو أرادني برحمة هل هن ممسكات رحمته قل حسبي الله عليه يتوكل المتوكلون.
These verses talks about the slaves of Allah, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for them. أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبِدَهُ. If a person is a true servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for him. That's why it's a question that the answer of it is definitely yes. That means, isn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for his slave? So this is such a beautiful meaning here, because if you want to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be on your side and to suffice for you, that means you don't need anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be a slave of Allah. And the more the person perfect his ubudiyah, his servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for him to help him and to guide him and so on. And what happens is that people would make the slaves of Allah, or they try to make them fear other than Allah. وَيُخَوِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ مِن دُونِهِ. They make you want to fear other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's of course weakens the matters of ibadah and matters of al-iman. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lead them astray, no one can guide them. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide, no one can lead them astray. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, and his revenge subhanahu wa ta'ala from those who are disbelievers and they oppose the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us, and of course for the disbelievers here, when it says and mentioning the physical signs from Allah, if you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they would say Allah. That means they know the favors of Allah. They know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth, but they don't worship him alone. So if they state the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth, then say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you see those who you invoke besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who you worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants harm from me, for me, would they be able to push away this harm? If Allah decreed harm for myself, would these idols that you worship besides Allah would push away the harm? Or if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants mercy for me, would they be able to withhold that mercy? Because there are idols being worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for me. عليه يتوكل المتوكلون. Upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who rely on Allah, they rely on Him. Relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And this is how the iman and the faith, when it becomes present in the heart with the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we heard, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides whoever He wills. And this is the tawheed, this is the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala, and this time with verses 42 to 45 from the same surah. Sheikh Ahmed, please go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها. الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها والتي لم تمت في منامها. الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها والتي لم تمت في منامها فيمسك التي قضى عليها الموت فيمسك التي قضى عليها الموت ويرسل الأخرى إلى أجل مسمى إن في ذلك لا أم اتخذوا من دون الله شفعاء قل قل لله الشفاعة جميعا قل لله الشفاعة جميعا له ملك السماوات والأرض قل لله الشفاعة جميعا له ملك السماوات والأرض ثم إليه ترجعون وإذا ذكر الله وحده اشمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة وإذا ذكر الذين من دونه إذا هم يستبشرون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses talks about some of the signs of Allah, one of which is sleep. Sleep is a minor death, and this is one of the great signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed it for the human beings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it this in the verse that we just heard, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take the souls when it sleeps. And some of them, they stay with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means a person die in his sleep. And those who they retain and they regain their souls again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them to life again when they wake up. And this is something that is a reminder for each and every one of us, that every time we sleep reminds us of the hereafter. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, whenever he would wake up from sleep, he would say, Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that gave us life after death. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we shall return. And these are ayat, signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who reflect, something that would make their hearts attached to the hereafter. The Prophet ﷺ ordered us to frequently mention death. Why? Because it reminds us of the hereafter and makes us have this life that we live in the right perspective. And then it talks about those who take besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as shufa'a, intercessors. These idols, they took them as intercessors between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't own the shafa'a. The shafa'a is owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't own anything and they do not have reason whatsoever or intellect. قُلْ لِلَّهِ الشَّفَاعَةُ جَمِيعًا. Say, O Muhammad sallam, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the shafa'a. And the shafa'a of the Prophet sallam, the shafa'a of the believers that is stated in the Quran and the sunnah of the Prophet sallam is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who would make the shafa'a intercession to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except by the permission of Allah? Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the shafa'a is for those who are upon the tawheed and those who died in the state of Islam. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belong what's in the heavens and what's in the earth, and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the verses talk about those who, whenever the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned alone, they become, their hearts become in state of disgust, those who disbelieve in the hereafter. But whenever the names of the partners that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, it makes them rejoice and happy and so on, which shows how that their hearts inverted. Instead of being upright and to be guided, the hearts are inverted, they do not see the truth, and that's why this is really the real punishment in this life that leads to the punishment in the hereafter. We continue inshallah ta'ala with the next verses, verses number 46 to 48, and Sheikh Fadim, please recite for us inshallah.
قل اللهم فاطر السماوات والأرض قل اللهم فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة عالم الغيب والشهادة أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون ولو أن للذين ظلموا ما في الأرض جميعا ومثله معه ولو أن للذين ظلموا ما في الأرض جميعا ومثله معه ولو أن للذين ظلموا ما في الأرض جميعا ومثله معه لافتدوا به من سوء العذاب يوم القيامة وبدا لهم من الله ما لم يكونوا يحتسبون يحتسبون وبدا لهم سيئات ما كسبوا وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون وبدا لهم سيئات ما كسبوا وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون.
Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ فَاطِرَ الْأَرْضِ. O Allah, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the knower of the unseen and the seen, you're the one that would judge between your slaves in whatever they differ among themselves in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between his slaves. All of the human beings shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between them. He's the most just subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the criteria that they will be judged based on, the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This Quran and the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why in the Day of Judgment, when people return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who transgressed, those who committed atrocities and injustices and disbelief and so on, as the verse says, that if they have the entire earth and whatever it contains and the like of it, they would ransom themselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the matter is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked for much, much easier than this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not ask the human beings in this life to ransom themselves with the entire wealth of the earth. But rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just asked them to obey him, to worship him alone, and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the disbelievers and the wrongdoers, they would see in the Day of Judgment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what they did not expect. Because they thought they would return, if there's a hereafter, as they said, they would return to the mercy of Allah. Based on what? What's the criteria for them to make this judgment? Why would a person say that if he returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will have mercy on him? Based on what? We have a revelation from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the matter very clear. If you want to return to the mercy of Allah, then follow the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. If a person doesn't, then why would he expect something that is not, he did not take the path of it? Why would people think that a ship would sail in the desert? It doesn't sail in the desert. It needs water for it to sail. The same thing, if a person wants to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's a path to it. And this path is not with wishful thinking, but rather with following the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the disbelievers, those who wrong themselves, then it will become very clear to them what they earned. What they've earned in this life, they would see it in the hereafter. If it's evil, evil. If it's good, it's good. And all of what they used to do of mockery would encircle them and make them be among the people of the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And then after that, inshallah ta'ala, we'll listen to verses from 49 to 52, also from the Surah Az-Zumar. And Sheikh Hamza, go ahead and cite for us, inshallah.
فَإِذَا مَسَّ الْإِنسَانَ ضُرٌّ دَعَانَا ثُمَّ إِذَا خَوَّلْنَاهُ نِعْمَةً مِنَّا قال إنما أوتيته على علم بل هي فتنة ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون قد قالها الذين من قبلهم قد قالها الذين من قبلهم فما أغنى عنهم ما كانوا يكسبون فأصابهم سيئات ما كسبوا والذين ظلموا من هؤلاء سيصيبهم سيئات ما كسبوا والذين ظلموا من هؤلاء سيصيبهم سيئات ما كسبوا وما هم بمعجزين أولم يعلموا أن الله يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء ويقدر إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون.
Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Verse that we heard the mean or the close of the meaning to it before, but with change of what is mentioned here, that if the human being harm touches him, he would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with invocation. Then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a favor from him subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does the slave of Allah would do? What the human being would usually do? They would say, I got this favor based on my knowledge. This is something that we hear all the time. When people are well established on the face of earth, they forget about the favors of Allah. They refer to themselves. They did. They're hard workers. They deserve it. They earned it. All of this. But this is in reality, it's a test from Allah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives someone something of his favor after he's been deprived from it, it's a test from Allah to see who is grateful to Allah. But most of the people, they fail miserably unless they follow the revelation from Allah. The Deen of Islam teaches us to be humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember that everything we have is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why one of the ways of imitating the ways of the disbelievers, that when a person is upon achievement or did something, a person would refer it to himself and give credit to himself. He'd say, I worked hard for this, I earned it, I this and that. Yes, people take the means, but where is the gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who's the one that gave you the ability to work hard? Who's the one that gave you the ability and the intellect and made the means for you? And that's why a person should say that he is grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to do the acts of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by being obedient to him. And the nations before, some of them, they did the same thing, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them as a result of that, because of what they used to earn. Like the cousin of Musa, Qarun, for example, he referred everything to himself. So whatever they earned of evil, it afflicted them. And those who transgress, whether they are at the time of the Prophet or any times, the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to happen to them. The evil of what they've earned would also afflict them, and nobody can escape from the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't they know, as the ayah says, أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Don't they know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that bestows the provisions upon whoever He wills, وَيَقْدِرُ, and withhold it with specific measures to others? This is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't they know that? And indeed, this is ayat, but only for لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ, for those who believe. The believers, they see this as signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and therefore always the believers, they do not take the full credit for things, but they are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped us, and they mean it and they acknowledge it with their hearts. And as a result of that, they don't use the favors of Allah to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to live a life of forgetfulness, to commit sins and to spread corruption on the face of earth, using the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the difference between the believers and the disbelievers, and this is how the believers, they witness the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are benefiting from it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from what we heard. And also may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward the reciters of these beautiful verses that reminded us of how to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to humble ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the benefits of these signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for listening. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who learn the Quran, among the people of the Quran, those who act according to the book of Allah. Until next time, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.